What's up, guys? This is Ray, and welcome to Age of Filmist. And I have another review of a thriller for you guys today, and that is the 2017 South Korean film Memoir of a Murderer. Memoir of a Murderer is directed by Won Shin-Yeon, and it stars Seo Kyung-Gu and Kim Nam-Gil. And I gotta say, Memoir of a Murderer is definitely one of my favorite South Korean thrillers. I mean, I think you can't go wrong with South Korean thrillers, generally speaking. I think South Korea makes some of the best thrillers out there, whether it be psychological thrillers, murder mystery thrillers, or in this case, a serial killer thriller. But Memoir of a Murderer, I think it's rather unique, especially when compared to some of the top Korean thrillers out there. I think it ranks way high up there. But the story, it's about this old dude by the name of Byung-Soo, and he has dementia in the sense that he can't really remember things correctly. He's one of those guys who flashes in and out of reality as far as what he sees or what he thinks is seeing. But Byung-Soo has a bit of a troubled past. Right before his dementia was triggered, he was actually a serial killer with a lot of killings under his belt. But one day, he has a car accident and hits the car of this young cop by the name of Tae-ju. And just by examining the damage that he did to his car, especially kind of examining the way that Tae-ju kind of brushed the accident off, Byung-Soo kind of figures Tae-ju to be some kind of serial killer himself. And as luck would have it, Tae-ju kind of finds his way back into Byung-Soo's life and starts dating his daughter. And as you can tell, things get really horribly messy from that point on. Or not really messy, but more kind of troublesome and chaotic. Now, I don't want to say too much about the story because I think that would dive into a lot of spoiler territory. I believe the less that one would describe about this movie, the better, just because there's a whole lot of fun to be had. It's really unique in itself. So, you know, when it comes to the positive of a Memoir of a Murder, well, you know, simply put, everything was bloody fantastic about this movie. But if I would have narrowed things down to what I like the most about Memoir of a Murder, it's its storytelling. Rather unique and very out of the box and just very cleverly written. For what I understand, this movie is an adaptation of a novel, and you can kind of feel the way it's shot and the way it's told through different scenes that it's definitely a well-written novel. And what I think is clever about Memoir of a Murderer's storytelling is that, you know, as I mentioned earlier, Byung-Soo has dementia, in that he flashes in and out of reality. He can't really remember straight. I think Alzheimer's is part of his condition. So you can't really trust his memory, or rather, you can't really trust anything he sees. And the movie makes the audience feel like they also have dementia, in that the audience doesn't really know what's real. They go through a lot of twists and turns, and they don't know what to expect at each twist and in each turn. The way it leads you down this path, or rather misleads you, it's intriguing, and it'll keep you on the edge of your seat. And it takes you down this mind trip, and it's very hard to get out of. But you know, what makes that work out is the performance of Seo Kyung-Gu. He was absolutely amazing. His performance comes with not only nuances and layers, but just intrigue. You just can't help but get drawn into his character. And, you know, first of all, Seo Kyung-Gu plays the kind of unlikely or uncommon type of hero, or rather, I should say, protagonist, because he isn't a hero. He has a dark personality. He's a serial killer. But at the same, you know, but he's a protagonist of the story. So of course you're gonna live the story through this guy's eyes. You're gonna want to cheer for this guy, and just having this kind of dark and twisted character, I think that was what intrigued me first of all when watching his performance. And because he is a unique type of protagonist, because his character is extremely well written, and because his performance has so many layers to it, it complements the twisted story that you follow in this movie. So needless to say, Seo Kyung-Gu, I think, is the best performer in this movie. But that doesn't mean the antagonist, played by Kim Nam-Gil, is bad. I mean, I think, if anything, Kim Nam-Gil deserves just as much praise for his performance as the antagonist Taeju. You know, Taeju comes off as this pretty boy, and you know, especially when you compare to Byung-soo. Byung-soo is like this old dude with dementia who, you know, normally people would scurry away from when encountered on the street, but Taeju is this charming guy with this young face. And this smile that can that makes it easy to hit on girls, and you know he's successful when he tries to date Byung-soo's daughter, of course, as the story goes. But even though they're drastically different in appearance, they are both equally dark and eerie, and the way the two performers play off of each other, it's fantastic. I mean, it's so much that they create this really intriguing cat and mouse game. That's because both characters are nowhere near heroes at all. And because of the very nature of the story, the outcome of this cat and mouse game is unpredictable as all hell. And because it's unpredictable, I think that makes it a damn near perfect thriller, because you're constantly kept at the edge of your seat, not knowing what's going to happen next, especially as each layer of the story is peeled away and you get to learn more about what's actually happening. You know, it's just amazing the way, you know, the payoff to all the suspense and to all the thrills, like, there is a big payoff. And so when it comes to the negatives, I don't have anything negative to say at all. I enjoy Memoir of a Murder from the start to the finish. And, you know, overall, it's a must watch. You have to see it. If you haven't seen it yet, you just have to watch it. If you're a fan of Korean thrillers, especially those involved or those centered around serial killers, this movie has it all. And what I like about this movie is that it does everything so well without resorting to hyper-violence. You know, granted, I love movies which are hyper-violent, but I like the way that Memoir of a Murder pulls off everything without having to resort to any of that. And not only because of the unpredictable nature, as I keep saying, the unpredictable nature, and also because of how many, the kind of twists and turns that are put into the story, and because of the very nature of the main character. Once you get to the end and everything that needs to be revealed is revealed, and once all the questions are answered, you're kind of left standing there thinking, you know, is everything that was revealed in fact true? Or rather, you'll be left sitting there thinking about how you should interpret it, especially when you get to the very end. It's like, all right, how should one interpret the story? Because I think the story is concluded in a very open-ended fashion, and it's something that could be discussed. It's just that damn good. But yes, needless to say, I definitely recommend this movie. As I keep saying, you gotta watch it. Yeah, end of story. And so yeah, those are my thoughts on Memoir of a Murder. What did you guys think? Or kind of questions did you guys have? Let me know in the comment section below. Please like, share, and subscribe. Follow me on Facebook and Twitter. And by all means, please support Age of Filmist on Patreon. It really helps the channel a lot. And as always, everyone, thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you all again in the next video. Take it easy.